In this video, we are going to work through an example problem in which we are separating a binary mixture using distillation. And in this particular case, we have two feeds coming into our column. We're given specific information about the feed flow rates and some of our operating conditions and our desired specifications for the purities in the distillate and bottom stream. So the question is, how many stages are needed to achieve this separation, and what is the optimal feed stage for feed one? So it's good to use some of the information that we have in the problem statement to label our diagram here on the left. Important to notice though, even though it's 1 and 2, that's referring to the feed streams and not the components. We are told that feed 1 is a saturated liquid, so we know the Q value of that must be equal to 1. However, we don't know the Q value of feed 2, but we are given information which we could calculate that, so we'll do that in a little bit. We're also given flow rates, so we could put that into our diagram. We know our outgoing specifications. And we're told that our reflux here, we are going to be operating at 2 times L over V min. It's always good to make sure we write down what we're looking for so that we could refer back to it. We want the number of stages and the feed location for 1. So at this point, let's go ahead and start with our approach for the problem. We're going to assume CMO, since our problem statement tells us that we can. So we could designate our vapor and liquid flow rates for each of the sections. It's typical to say that our vapor in our top rectifying section is labeled as big V, and we have a liquid flowing back into our column as L. When we have our feed entering, these flow rates could change, so we're going to designate them with a prime. And then below our feed too, again, they might be different, so we're going to designate those with a bar symbol. Important to know that with our partial reboiler, the vapor leaving it is going to be the vapor in the bottom stripping section, and the liquid leaving the column is going to be the liquid entering our partial reboiler. So a good place to start is by doing our mass balances on the overall column. We could do an overall balance and a component balance, so let's start there. So our overall balance, we know that feed 1 plus feed 2 has to be what's leaving the column in our distillate and our bottom stream. We have information regarding these, so we know 100 plus 200 has to equal D plus B. We could also do our component balance for acetone. We're also given information for this equation. I've filled in the values here. So we could use our overall balance and substitute for D or B in this case and plug into our component balance to solve, since we have two equations, two unknowns. And when I solve, I get B is equal to 150 moles per hour, which means from our overall balance that D must also equal 150 moles per hour. So in order to determine the amount of stages that we're going to use to achieve this separation, we could use a McCabe-Thiele diagram to do this. This means we would need to collect phase equilibrium data for our acetone and methanol system and plot them on a Y versus X mole fraction diagram. To determine our operating lines for each of these sections, we want to perform material balances around these different sections. For instance, let's start with a balance around the top of our column. So if we wanted to determine our operating line for our rectifying section, we could draw a box and write our material balance coming in and out of this box. So we know that V is coming in, and we have that equal to D plus L. From the problem statement, we're told that we're operating at 2 times the minimum. And we could determine the minimum from our phase equilibrium data by drawing a line from our distillate composition to where our feed intersects with the phase equilibrium line. Let's take a look. So we're told we have saturated liquid at 0.7. So a saturated liquid operating line would be vertical from our 0.7, shown like this. So we know that our rectifying operating line has to intersect at the distillate composition on the x equals y line, which would be at 0.95. To determine the minimum reflux or minimum amount of liquid that we send back into our column, we would have an infinite amount of stages, which would mean we would intersect here on the phase equilibrium line. So now we have a line that symbolizes our L over V min, because L over V is the slope of that line, and we can work that out through doing our material balances over that section, as we were just doing, if we included the component balance, even though they're unknown. So we could determine the slope by just choosing the two points of our intersections, and we determine that the slope is roughly about 0.32. So as I mentioned, our operating line is a combination of both the overall and component material balances. So you can see our slope is L over V. I apologize, I rewrote this wrong over here. That should be L over V min. And we decided from our slope on our X equals Y line that that slope was 0.32. So 2 times this would be 0.64. Because we know we're going to be interested in determining what V prime, L prime, V bar, and L bar are later, we're going to go ahead and solve for what L and V are using our material balance. Substituting in our L over V that we're operating at, we get V equals 417 and L equals 267. Remember, those are moles per hour. We can go back to our chart and now erase this line since that's not what we're operating at and plug in our line for our actual operating conditions, which should have a slope of 0.64. Using the intercept, calculate it to be 0.34. So if we pick 2 points on that line, the slope should be 0.64, and you could do that just as a validation. So if we repeat the same kind of methodology for our middle operating section, we could use the top and plot something that goes through our middle section. When we write out the material balances for this, we could rearrange into our familiar operating line equation, where the slope of the line will be L prime over V prime. The rest of this here will be our y-intercept. So to be able to draw this line on our y-x diagram, we'd have to know what L prime and V prime are. So since we know V and L, and we have information about F, we could do a balance around our feed to figure out what these flow rates are in the middle section. So our feed's going to come into our feed tray, and whatever amount of vapor exists in the feed is going to go up, and whatever amount of liquid is going to go down. Now we're told we have a saturated liquid, which means that VF is equal to zero and LF is equal to our feed flow rate since it's all saturated liquid. So we can say that L prime is equal to L plus LF, which in this case LF could be rewritten as just our feed flow rate. And we happen to know both of these values, so our L prime must be 367. Now V would be equal to V prime plus FV. But since there's no vapor in our feed, this is just going to be equal to V prime. So our vapor flow rate V in the top section is just equal to our vapor flow rate in the middle section, V prime. This also means we could calculate what the slope of our operating line in the middle is going to be as L prime over V prime, and I get a value of 0.88. So we know that our middle operating line has to intersect our top operating line at the feed. So we could determine what the intercept is on the y-axis using our slope. So we're going to go ahead and do that. So using 2 points, we could use that intercept, which we said before was 0.79 minus what we're looking for, y over 0.7 minus 0. Since we're looking for our y-intercept, we could solve for y, and we get about 0.17. So now we could draw our operating line from this intercept to a y-intercept of 0.17. And that gives us a line for our middle operating section. So I'm going to go ahead and take our other line and shrink it down. So now we have our top operating line. We have our F1 feed line. We have a line for our middle section. All we have left now is our second feed and our bottom operating line. So at this point in time, we have 3 of our lines out of 5 already drawn on our plot. We need 2 more. So we could choose whichever one we want, and the fifth has to fall in place to satisfy our material balances. So we're going to go ahead and do a material balance over our second feed stage. And I've drawn what that might look like here with our appropriate labeling of our flow rates. And we're told that it's a superheated vapor. So VF is just going to be equal to F2, and LF is going to be equal to 0. But we also have some of the liquid coming down that gets vaporized. So we know L bar is going to be less than L prime, and V prime is going to be greater than V bar. If we write a balance, we can say L bar is equal to L prime plus LF, which we said was 0, minus the fraction of L prime that's vaporized. Now we're given that in our problem statement. We're told that for every 10 moles of feed, 1 mole of liquid on the feed stage will vaporize. So we know we have 200 moles coming in, so we could determine what L bar is going to be. Now our feed operating line we've derived before, it's related to our Q by the following equation. So we only need L bar to calculate Q because Q is the amount of liquid that crosses our feed plate in comparison to the amount of liquid that entered our feed plate. So in this case it'd be L bar minus L prime over F2. When we plug numbers in and solve for our Q, we get negative 0.1. So we get a slope of 0.09 and a y-intercept plugging in our known feed composition of 0.36. So we know our second feed has a composition of 0.4, so we start at the x equals y line. We know our y-intercept is 0.364, so we could draw our second feed. So this is our operating line for our second feed. So we know that where these intersect, our stripping section must start and go to our bottom's composition on the x equals y line. You could show this using the material balances and keep going, or you could just draw the line on the McCabe-Thiele diagram. So now we have our five operating lines. I'm just going to clean this up a little bit. So at this point, we can start drawing our stages. We would start at the top. Since we have a total condenser, that's our stage one. I would continue this until we get to crossing our first operating line, and we go down to our second. And since I've shortened those lines, it's a little easier to do this. And I'll just continue doing this until we get to our bottom's composition. And you can see I didn't quite end where we wanted to, so we probably add one last stage, which in this case is our partial reboiler. So we have six and our partial reboiler. Our optimal feed for our first plate is at the third stage. So feed one is fed at the third stage, and that's optimal. And our feed two would be fed at the fifth stage.